understand the challenge that's before me, and I'll build off of the success that we see here in San Diego.
San Diego Unified School District Superintendent Cindy Marten is now the nation's Deputy Education Secretary. ABC 10 News reporter Rena Nakano spoke with Marten, as well as her critics, about her confirmation.
For 8 years, Cindy Marten was the leader in the San Diego Unified School District. Now she's the nation's number two in education.
I want to share my gratitude with our president and the Senate, and really all of San Diego.
The U.S. Senate voted 54-44 Tuesday to confirm Marten. The 32-year educator has been praised for producing one of the highest graduation rates in all of the state's largest urban districts.
All across this fine nation, the needs are very different, but we're used to here in San Diego delivering on the hope and the promise and understanding what a good, solid public education can do for our kids.
But district parent Tanya Daniels says her sons were stripped of a good public education.
I think it's egregious and it's a slap in the face.
Daniels is suing the district after she claims her sons were bullied and beaten at Lincoln High School. Daniels says she brought up the issues with Marten but claims she ignored them. Her sons never returned to school.
I am doubtful that she will change. A zebra doesn't change its stripes.
The NAACP and other parent groups have also been critical since Biden's nomination of Marten.
The suspension rate for our Black students continues in San Diego to be astronomically high.
Marisol Quevedo-Rerucha understands that Martin's role won't be the same at the national level, but hopes she takes the extra effort to listen to parents.
Parent voice matters. You know, and what our parents and our students experience matters and can't be swept under the rug.
Let's face the challenge, let's work for our recovery, and I do this with a full heart and having a lot of gratitude as the ability to serve.
Rena Nakano, ABC 10 News.
After Marten's resignation, Dr. Lamont Jackson was appointed as the interim superintendent. The district will announce its selection of a permanent superintendent by December.